Hello and welcome to Module 3 on Nuclear Fusion. In the first section, we're going to be learning about fusion basics, and then in the second section, we'll be learning about magnetic confinement fusion, and in the third section, we'll be discussing innovation and future directions in the field of fusion energy research. This is Fusion Basics, Module 3.1. Fusion is everywhere in the universe. A constant reminder of this is when you look up into the night sky and see the stars, or go out during the day and see the sun. Nuclear fusion is a physical process that combines light nuclei to make heavier nuclei. It is the process that powers every star in the universe, including the nearest one, our sun. As we'll learn throughout this module, there are many possible fusion reactions. For example, in the sun, we often say that it is a burning ball of gas. This means that the sun is fusing or burning hydrogen, the symbol H, making helium, the symbol He, and in the process, releasing the nuclear fusion energy. Fusion energy research, however, refers to a much broader field and a much broader topic than just those fusion reactions. Fusion energy research has the goal to build a fusion power station to make clean electricity from fusion reactions. Fusion energy research refers to an entire branch of science and engineering which is dedicated to harnessing fusion reactions for the benefit of mankind. Shown here in this diagram below is an example of how we generate and transmit electricity to an end user, for example, like you, sitting at home. On the left, you can see that we might generate electricity with a coal power plant, or with a hydroelectric power plant, or with a nuclear power plant, and you learned about how fission power plants work from Professor Buongiorno in Module 2. So the goal of fusion energy research is to really take fusion reactions and learn how to control them and confine them so that we can build a fusion power station to produce clean electricity. Fusion energy research as a field is constantly pushing the frontiers of science and technology. Fusion itself began as a separate field of science in the middle of the 20th century. You can read more about the history at this online source, the Encyclopedia Britannica, and we also have some really nice notes on this online in the course sections. What you may already know about fusion is the joke, that fusion is 30 years away and always will be. It's true that fusion is very difficult to make happen in the conditions on Earth, and that's what we're going to learn about in this module on fusion basics. However, it's good to take note that scientists do make fusion reactions occur successfully in the lab all the time on a fairly routine basis. Fusion energy research is an exciting and fast-moving international research area. In this module, also, we're going to discuss that old joke might not be so funny anymore, because we're going to be talking about that there really are viable and near-term paths to building fusion power stations less than 30 years away. Fusion reactions are pretty exotic then. They're happening in the sun and in the stars and in very specialized conditions under the control of scientists in the laboratory. To understand why fusion reactions are so hard to make happen, let's look at some of the conditions for these reactions to occur. First, it's important that we note that fusion is the opposite process to fission, which we learned about in Module 2. In fission, as shown in the diagram, heavier elements will break apart to form lighter elements. Fusion is then taking the lighter elements and bringing them together to form heavier elements, as shown in the diagram. This is why we say that we are combining light nuclei in fusion reactions. If we want to create a new element in the periodic table, then heavier elements, things that are heavier than iron, shown on the right-hand side of the diagram, would have to undergo fission processes. This diagram is the binding energy curve that you may remember from Module 1, and you can read more about it in the notes from Module 1, as well as the notes for this module. On the left-hand side of this plot, you'll note that the elements lighter than iron can actually undergo fusion processes to build up new elements. As this process occurs, the energy that is released can be calculated for the many different possible fusion reactions. For examples of these calculations, please see the assessments and the notes for this section online.